Hi, this is Chris Masiello of VitaminCM.com, and today I'm going to show you how to use pivot tables to analyze your Excel data more effectively. I have a sales report here that's tracking fruit sales by day and by product. As you can see, I have the products going down the side and the days going across the top, and you can see the total sales each day and then the totals for the week. Now, where all this data came from was this detail tab. So in the detail tab, you can see each day, each product that was sold and how much of it was sold. And you can see I have 8 different products here. So I have apples that were imported. I have bananas, I have grapes, I have oranges, peaches, watermelon. Some of them are local, some of them are imported, and I'm tracking each of them. What you can do to track your data more effectively is use a pivot table. So if I select my whole range of data here, and I go to Insert and select Pivot Table, I have some options. So do I want to select a range? I can change the range here. I could select all the columns, even if there's empty cells. I can use an external data source. I can place the pivot table in a new worksheet or inside this existing one. I typically like to go in a new one because it looks a little more clean. So I'll hit OK. And it creates a new spreadsheet in this, and it creates a new worksheet in this file where I can build my pivot table. So here are all the fields I had, the 4 fields on my report: product, origin, day, and sales. And I can organize them into these areas so I can decide what my row labels will be. And I want to list my products down my rows. And you can see it lists them here. And I want to list my days across the columns. So I'll put that in column labels. And you can see it adds that in. And for values, that's got to be something with a numeric value. And of course, that's going to be my sales figures. So I'll drop that in. Now, if I click on this and go to value field settings, you can do a few things. So you see, it's giving me the sum of the sales. I could do the count. I could do the average, minimum, maximum, etc. I could also go to number format here. And these are dollars, so I want to put it as currency. And click OK, and you'll see there's my information. Now, if I want to use this report filter area, I can take the origin field and drop it in there. And as you notice, when I open that up, I have all by default. Then I can select imported or local or both. So if I select both, you'll see it shows them. If I go back and I select it to only imported, you'll see it will only show products where I have an imported variety, and it will show the dollars for that. If I switch it to local, it will show me a different product mix, and it will show me the sales for those. Or I could put it back to all. Now, this is nice. If you notice, it looks just like this report that I showed you before, but the difference is this report is not flexible. This is how it's going to stay, and I'd have to do a lot of work to display it in a different way. But if I come back here and I look at this report, and let's say instead of wanting to see my days across the columns and my products in the labels, I could switch them. So I could drag my day down here to row labels, and I could drag my products up here to column labels. See, it automatically redraws itself, and it retotals everything up and figures itself out. Next thing I could do here, same thing. I could filter and I could say I only want to see apples and oranges. I could sort them alphabetically in reverse or forward. Now, one of the things that you could do here is I have this filter at the top for origin. So if I take that field and drag it out of there and drag it inside of my column labels, you'll notice I have 2 groupings, and I'm going to actually collapse them here so you can see. So here are sales of all my imported fruits, and here are sales of all my local fruits. And if I expand local, you'll see that I have grapes, oranges, and peaches, and here's what they total. If I expand imported, you'll see I have apples, bananas, and watermelon. And here they are individually, and here's what they total. And I could even switch that again if I drag origin below product. So now product will be the nesting. And if there were any where I had an imported and a local variety, I would see it group as such. Then I could just drag it back out and set it back to its original. And then let's say I still don't like it with the products going across the columns, I could switch it again put it back, and now it will look just like that other report that we originally started with. So this is a pretty effective way that you can take your data and look at it in any number of ways. Now, another cool thing about it is, if I go back to this detail, and let's say I was messing around with my sales figures and I realized they were off and I changed them. So I changed a couple of the sales figures here, and I go back up to my pivot table. If I do refresh, you'll notice some of my numbers change. Now, the other nice thing is this data will be dynamic fresh when you add data and come back here and hit refresh. You could also run calculations against it. So if I did, let's say, average, and I wanted to average my sales by day, I could come back here, go to my details, change the number. Then if I hit refresh, you'll see it changed the numbers, and the calculation that I put against them also changed. So that's a way to use pivot tables to analyze your data more flexibly and effectively.